what? You can talk about Ryan Gosling all day, but the moment I
about this baby. I don't think I can do it.
What? Why? Why, it's perfect. It's our chance to have a baby that's part me, part you.
No, it's part you and part Claire. I'm nowhere in there. And it's not like I can pretend. She's not some egg donor that we don't know. It's Claire. You know, we see her all the time. And what are we supposed to tell the baby? Say hi to your Aunt Mommy.
Adorable.
No, not adorable. Appellation. I'm sorry, Cam.
Jay, Claire has offered to give us one of her eggs so we can have a baby that's half Pritchett, half Tucker.
That's unnatural. I'm against it.
Oh, surprise, surprise. Jay is against something.
Cam and Claire want to have a baby together. You're not going to do that.
It's not your decision, Dad.
You're not thinking straight.
And you're not in charge. Okay, Claire and I are adults. If we want this to happen, it's going to happen.
El bebé es mi familia y no va a ser educado por extraños.
She's saying that she's going to raise the baby.
No. Cam.
Mitchell, where are you going?
I'm just sick of it, Cam.
Mitchell, come back here and talk to me. There are coyotes out here and meth addicts.
Every time, Cam, every time someone says that we're getting a baby, I get my hopes up. And then when it all falls apart, we just have to go through the whole thing again. And then meanwhile, the child that we do have is at a recital and we're missing it.
No. I'm as frustrated as you are.
Are you? Because I don't know how much more of this I can take. I am so tired. And just disappointed. I'm just tired.
Let's take a break.
Really?
It must be. Exhausting, always keeping it together for the both of us.
Moments in life that you never forget.
Oh, you dropped a little clipboard.
I thought you had a work dinner tonight.
I did, but I blew them off. I'd rather be here supporting the team. You better go, Dolphins!
Okay. Yeah, love that, but you know, the game's almost over. You might want to beat traffic, so.
I thought you'd be happy that I was here. Why do I feel like you're trying to get rid of me?
I have no idea. It's not because you're a jinx.
A jinx? Do you think I'm a jinx?
No. This all can't be on you.
I'm hearing a lot of things that sound like the opposite
Coach,
of what you're...
We need a play! And Malcolm just got stung by a bee!
I gotta go. A bee! Okay, get some baking soda!
What? I thought you said...
Yeah, Mom shot Jay and Claire said to him.
Dad, you would rather take a bullet than support your granddaughter?
This was really Gloria's idea.
I am surrounded by rats.
Mitchell, listen to me. I know I'm sorry barely covers it, but it's very difficult for me to come here today and watch little girls playing soccer on the same day that my little girl left for college.
Well, me too. I mean, watching my little grandbaby go off.
Don't jump on my thing.
My dad still isn't completely comfortable with this. He still does this thing. It's been 5 years now, and he still does this thing where he announces himself before walking into any room we're in, just to make sure he doesn't have to ever see us kiss.
Yeah. We're here, coming in.
Don't worry, Dad, nothing gay going on here. About that, I have something that I need to tell you guys. We didn't just go to Vietnam for pleasure. We kind of have some big news.
Oh, God, if Cam comes out here with boobs, I'm leaving.
Dad?
I hope he didn't embarrass you, Mom.
Oh, don't mind her. Haley had her first boy over today, and Phil shot him.
Anyway, so about a year ago, Cam and I started feeling this longing, you know, for something more, like maybe a baby.
Ooh, that's a bad idea.
What do you mean, bad idea?
Well, kids need a mother. I mean, if you two guys are bored, get a dog.
Okay, we're not bored. Dad.
I support you, Mitchell, even though you're not my son.
I think what Dad is trying to say is that, Mitchell, you're a little uptight. Kids bring chaos, and you don't handle it well.
Oh, that's not what Dad's saying. That's what you're saying, and it's insulting in a whole different way.
Okay, people, let's all chillax.
Hey, where's Uncle Cameron?
Fine, thank you. Thank you. Someone who's not insulting me notices he's not here.
Oh, so that's the big announcement, huh? you two broke up. Well, a baby wasn't going to help that anyway. And you know, let me tell you, you're a little better off because he was a bit of a drama queen.
No, stop. No, you come into my house and you insult me and my boyfriend, who, by the way, is not that dramatic. And, oh, God.
About a plane ticket to surprise us on the 4th of July. That's why my credit card was over the limit.
Now I feel bad for yelling at him.
Yeah, me too. Well, don't make me wrestle you down.
Who's this?
Oh, dear.
Well, Grams, this is Bud, our new farmhand.
Bud?
Yeah, Bud's a little simple-minded on account of getting mule kicked, isn't he? And you know the rules on being in the house, Bud. Now go on outside. We're going to milk the cows in a few minutes. Get on out there. Have a treat after.
I'm done.
Come on, please, just be Bud for a couple days. You can do some chores. Maybe I can berate you a little bit to really sell it.
Do you hear how insane you sound? Chores? All right, you know what? You deal with your grandmother however you want. Lily and I will just go get a hotel room. Some budget cuts at the office and a bunch of us got laid off. Now, I didn't tell Cam because I was embarrassed, but also because I knew I would get another job like that. It's been a month, and now it's just weird that I didn't tell him in the first place. So every morning I leave for work. Well, hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to work I go. Okay. I send out my resume. And then, like most unemployed people hiding the truth from their spouses, I go to the park. And Cam, George is a bird, and Spencer is an old man I've been hanging out with at the park because I got laid off.
You lost your job?
I'm sorry, I couldn't tell you that I was out of work again. I feel like such a loser.
No, please, my gosh, as long as you're not cheating on me, that's all that matters. Something will come up, you're a great lawyer.
Thank you. I don't think that we can get that apartment right now.
Oh, hey. I thought you were going to the pharmacy.
I forgot my phone.
Oh.
I think I'm just upset about the stupid thing with my dad.
Whoa, sweetie, I'd love to hear about it when you come back with my heating pad from the pharmacy because I hurt my back, remember?
I mean, did he ever react or what? It's just a game, right?
Well, unless there's something more to it. Maybe you should go talk to him.
Yeah.
Huh?
Oh, I should have just kept my mouth shut. I mean, it was such a great day. After he thought he got that hole-in-one, he took us out to dinner, he bought me my first beer.
Well, there you go. He's probably hurt because you marred a very special father-son experience.
You think?
You marred it. But you can fix it. He's down at the club right now. Go, Mitchell. Unmar that memory.
You know what? I'm gonna do it.
Oh.
Sorry. It meant a lot to me, too. We had a steak dinner, you gave me my first beer, and, it was one of the greatest days we ever spent together, and it wasn't about some meaningless hole-in-one. It was about us.
No, it was about a hole-in-one.
Yes, a little bit, maybe, but mostly it was about how we bonded.
I thought I hit a ball straight from a tee, really, really far, into a tiny hole.
Okay. When will I learn?
Your mom yelled at you in front of all your friends, said you were just a baby. You ran outside in tears, which unfortunately supported your mom's argument. Anyway, I came out with a couple of beers. We drank them on the porch, watching the storm clouds coming in.
I had completely forgotten about that. You know, you're unbelievable. Just when I pegged you...
Storm Stevens, that's it! Give me something. I'm gonna write it right here. Before I forget, Storm Stevens. What were we just talking about just now?
Oh.
No?
Uh-uh.
Last year, one of my... Is everything okay, honey?
Oh, you walked over here. I just thought you Ubered everywhere.
Okay,
I gotta breathe. That's still free, isn't it?
Mitchell, it's not that bad.
Really? Because I haven't worked in weeks. I have no prospects. We're living off of a gym teacher's salary, and somehow I let you talk me into buying the apartment upstairs.
What's going on? Are we...
It's growing?
Yes.
What the hell? Why are you so good?
I don't know. I'm just good at most things.
So am I, usually.
Wait a second. So is Sanjay. I have to get to him before he leaves.
Wow, you're really getting better.
Maybe you should go inside.
Ow.
Really thought I was done with that one.
How's it going?
Got a splinter and a few other issues.
You know what's happening here, don't you? You're having a midlife crisis.
Oh, my God.
Some guys, it's fast cars and women. Me, it was golf. You, just a little gayer.
I know like 10 lesbians who could out-golf you.
Point is, when you're wound as tight as we are, you're bound to snap.
Yeah. Yeah, I've just been working so hard for so long. Now that I've stopped, I'm having a hard time starting again.
Oh, I get it. I took 6 weeks off one summer just to play golf. And one day during the big club tournament, I hooked a 7-iron out of bounds. I got so pissed, I wrapped the club around a tree. You're a great lawyer. Go do that. Get a haircut.
Hello.
Hey, Dad, did you know that the accident was Gloria's fault?
Yes.
I mean, I wasn't there,
but she's a horrible driver. If she hit 10 cars, I wouldn't be surprised.
If you knew that it was her fault, why did you get me involved?
Because someone has to tell her she's in the wrong and better you than me.
That's great. Here I am thinking that my dad actually respects me as a lawyer, and really you're just throwing me to the wolves.
Can it be both?
Okay, Dad, it doesn't bother you in the least that your gay son's the only one tough enough to stand up to your wife?
Go get him, Rocky. See you later.
He referred to me as a friend of my son.
Seriously?
Yeah.
That's a little disrespectful to you.
Well, I wasn't offended by it.
Well, I am. I mean, would he refer to Phil as a friend of Claire's? No.
I've heard him call Phil a lot worse. Just let it pass. No, I should have never said anything.
No, I'm not letting it pass. He needs to know that that's not okay. And if he doesn't like it, he knows where he can go.
Enter a destination.
Hell.
I came out of the closet in my mid-20s. I had to actually come out to my dad 3 times before he finally acknowledged it. I'm not sure if maybe he was hoping he heard it wrong, like I had said, Dad, I'm gray.
And my parents, they always just knew. My mother says labor with me took 30.
What's the matter?
A friend of my son, that's how you introduced Cam?
That's why you came here.
Dad, it's just more than a little insulting. Cam and I have been together for 5 years. We have a daughter.
Look at these guys. They look like they came out of the 1800s. You see Hugo over there? After lunch, he ordered a Senka.
No, they're not the ones that are uncomfortable with this. You are. You've never been completely accepting of me, and now that I have a family, it's getting a little old.
These guys don't understand the gay thing. Why create an awkward situation? That's all I'm saying.
That's weird, because your friend Shorty there, gay as they come. When I was back east in law school, my dad used to call me every Saturday at 6 p.m., before people would go out, just, you know, check in, catch up. And then I think the Christmas of my second year, I finally got up the courage to tell him. After that, I pretty much just talked to my mom. I'm not crying. Well, I'm so sorry.
And why are you smiling?
I'm proud of you, Dad. You know, you're growing.
Just stop it. Please, don't you see how hard this is for me? See, I used to be just like one of those guys. Now look at me. I got a house looks like little Columbia. I got a gay son and a Chinese granddaughter.
Vietnamese?
Only you would know the difference.
Okay, don't worry, Dad. Not growing too much.
For the better part of a half hour, I screamed the death out of your meat. Now what do you want from me?
Don't you see? It's because of you that your son cannot kiss his own lover.
Don't we don't like say lover.
Can we just eat?
No. Tell Mitch that it's okay to kiss Cam in front of you.
Why is that something we have to do?
We don't.
Of course we don't.
Oh, I'm sorry that I don't want to make out with you in front of my whole family.
No need to apologize.
No, Gloria is right. Dad, you being so emotionally closed off makes it very difficult for your children to show affection.
Really?
Yes.
You had trouble showing. How about you're welcome? How about I'm so happy to be here for you all so I can take the blame for all your crap. I can't do this. I never did that. Trust me. I gave you twice as much as my father ever gave me. The man kissed me one time in my entire life. Came up behind me, kissed me in the back of the head, said, "Good night, Becky." He thought I was my sister.
Wait a minute. What was the last time you kissed Mitch?
What does that have to do with anything?
Mitch, what was the last time he kissed you?
I don't remember.
It wasn't that long ago.
I was 12.
12? This is the problem. Jay's dad doesn't kiss Jay, so Jay doesn't kiss Mitch, and Mitch is uptight.
Okay, uptight was really not on the table. This is more about kissing.
Jay, kiss your son. He's a mess.
Oh, come on now.
We don't have to do that. It's...
Yes, you do.
No,
come on, do it. You're in front of your grandchildren. Wait, why don't you make her fix this instead of you doing it as usual?
Oh, what's that supposed to mean?
Well, your mom makes a mess, and there's Mitchell to clean it up.
Okay, but that is so not true. If anything, you're the one with the screwed up relationship with mommy. with mom.
Mommy.
No, I didn't say that. Damn it.
Ooh. Fine. Fine.
Listen, she's a wreck about what happened at the wedding, and she wants to come to dinner tonight to apologize to everyone.
Still her little errand boy, I see.
Now, why does everybody keep saying... No, I'm just trying to piece this family back together. So you'll talk to Glory about mom coming to dinner?
Oh, Glory will never go for that in a million years. She's still furious with your mother.
Which is why I'm not talking to you.
What did I do?
This conversation never took place.
Well, that's not very nice. I drove all the way here.
No, you didn't. You were never here. In fact, you never even called.
I would have called, but I thought it would be better to talk about that. What's happening here?
Listen, I would love to get this thing behind us. But Gloria would never forgive me if I pulled a fast one on her. That's why you're going to pull a fast one on her, and I'm not going to like it one bit.
Okay, that's just great. No, it's great. So it's solid to me.
I can't hear you because you're back home and I'm taking a nap.
Go.
Oh, wait.
Last time you were over at the house, you were looking at that photo album. What'd you do with it?
Oh, Dad, that was me. I think I put it on the shelf behind the bar.
What are you doing there?
They asked me to come along in case they needed a lawyer.
Shouldn't they have a real lawyer?
Oh, God, should we?
I am a real lawyer, people. Environmental law is a thing.
Don't get all sensitive on me. I mean, someone who doesn't defend pandas.
Yeah, Dad, because that's what I do. I defend pandas in court.
That's adorable.
You know what I'm talking about.
Haley needs someone who knows criminal law, like Perry Mason.
Okay, so I'm not a real lawyer, but Perry Mason is?
Oh, hell.
What is taking so long?
Well, in my experience, these things can take time, so settle in. This could be a while.
There she is.
Damn it.
Oh, my God.
All right, that's my boy! Just to bug me, you know, because there was never a trophy in my house. Not until this one.
Oh, that's a good grip.
Wow, this means more to Dad than it does to Manny.
Yeah, it's his chance to be a father of a champion. Well, second chance.
Thank you.
We all know how the first time went.
Took me some time to sneak out without waking her up.
Kind of like the first time you slept over here.
I had a meeting. All right, let's talk about why you got your panties in a bunch. What's up with you and your sister?
Nothing is up.
Mm-hmm. Or could this have something to do with ice skating? When Mitchell and Claire were kids...
This is interesting to know.
Please let me finish. Thank you. When Mitchell was 10...
11.
And Claire was 13, they were competitive ice dancers.
Figure skaters. Oh, for God's sakes, I'll tell the story. Yes, my sister and I were actually a very good team. We were called Fire and Nice. I was Fire, because of the red hair. And Claire was Nice, because it was ironic, and she wasn't.
And Mitchell is still upset because Claire quit the team right before some meet.
Some meet. The 13 and under regional championships. Just the Emerald City at the end of my yellow brick road.
Wow, you did it.
What?
You made figure skating sound even gayer. So seeing your dad so proud of Manny didn't stir up any resentment?
Mm-mm.
Okay, fine. You always do this. Instead of letting your feelings out, you bury them, and then they bubble up later in hurtful ways.
Okay, you know what? Yes, all right, listen. I might still be holding a little resentment, but that's embarrassing and petty, and it's not a good color on me. It's kind of like you in yellow.
You love me in my yellow shirt.
It makes you look like the sun.
Okay. Bubbling. Hurtful bubbling. Now you know why I left early that morning.
Ha! I knew you didn't have a meeting, Cam. I knew it.
Come on.
Thanks, Cam.
Is he serious? Is that what your little jab was about this morning?
Okay, no, yes. Okay, yes. I guess I'm still a little angry. But, you know, you stole my moment, Claire.
Yeah, 21 years ago.
Okay, no, but it doesn't matter to you because you had your own moments. You had cheerleading and high school plays and making out with the quarterback.
Oh, come on, you made out with him too.
Yeah, but we had to keep it a secret. You shouldn't have quit. It was selfish.
You want to know why I quit? I quit to protect you.
From what? Glory? Fame?
No, come on. I was bigger than you. I was bigger than you, and I was afraid you wouldn't be able to lift me. You were dropping me in practice, and I didn't want you to humiliate yourself in front of all of those people. You drop me all the time. Come on. Could you just forgive me and move on?
Of course. Yes, of course. I'm sorry. It would have been nice to see him that proud of us. By us, I mean me.
And you sincerely thought that the path to Dad's approval was going to be through figure skating? Mitchell, I am fairly confident that Dad's proudest moment was when you finally took off the flame red unitard.
I am not claiming that any of this is rational. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for being such a pill, okay? Let's face it, we've kind of grown apart in the past few years. And with Mom and Dad's divorce, we were on opposing sides, and I miss being on your team.
That's... little gang.
Fun!
Mitchell, care to go first?
I'll give it a whirl.
Running into my dad was no accident. I wasn't the best athlete growing up, and my dad never missed an opportunity to point that out. Nice throw, Nancy. Nancy was our neighbor. I could never throw as well as she could. I'd pretty much given up on beating my dad at anything until Pepper dragged me to a golf course one day. Turns out, I wasn't half bad. 6 months practice later, I was ready to kick my dad's ass. I knew just how I was gonna do it too. I'd walk up to the tee, all nervous, do a few clumsy practice swings, and then I'd hit that ball dead center, watch it arc through the sky, land on the green, and totally wow my dad.
Wow.
What is happening to me? All right, what are we, 3 strokes down now?
I think someone needs a pepper talk.
Ah, ow! How is that a pepper talk?
You need to get angry. Play aggressive. That man's been Mitch-slapping you your entire life.
I know, but he's being so nice to Phil, and Phil is way worse than I ever was. I don't know. Maybe he's not the unsympathetic jerk he used to be.
Okay, so you got...
Did you hear that? And he wasn't just talking to Phil. He was talking to 10-year-old Hugh and 12-year-old Hugh.
Suck it, Nancy!
I was just trying to help.
I should have golfed with you sooner, Dad.
I never made the time.
Because I am Raymond.
What?
Yeah, if we ever broke up, all of our friends would pick you, and I'd be the one who's left behind.
Oh, honey, that's not true. I don't think I'm out of line suggesting my friends don't want to see a father-son dance at a big gay wedding.
There is no father-son dance, Dad.
I don't know what things go on there. Do I walk you down the aisle? Does someone throw a bouquet? I mean, I'm just saying, I don't know how this stuff plays out with my guys from the club.
Oh, you mean the guys who sit around the locker room watching football naked? No, this isn't about them. This is about you. You are the one that's uncomfortable here.
Fine, I admit it. This whole wedding thing is weird to me.
Wow.
Now see, why do you get to be you, but I don't get to be me? See, I didn't choose to be uncomfortable. I was born this way.
Are you really throwing a gay anthem in our face right now?
Damn it, give me some credit. You know how far I've come. I mean, what more do you want from me?
You know what, Dad? You do. You get to be you. If it really makes you that uncomfortable, then don't come to the wedding.
Hi,
Mitchell.
No, see, we're scaling back already.
Hey, Phil, it's Mitchell, Claire's brother. I heard about your and Claire's whole pregnancy situation, and I'm sorry my dad didn't have a better reaction.
How?
Really? Because unlike you, the... Mm-hmm. You get to remember telling her you loved her and laughing, and I get to remember getting in some stupid argument about a Facebook post.
The one where...
You know who would get this? Dee Dee. And damn if I wasn't depressed.
Yeah.